Hello, everyone, and welcome to the Salter Family Theater for our production of Including Shooter. Please take note of your exits, which are located to the back and right side of the theater. Eating and drinking are not permitted inside of the theater. Please refrain from using any cellular devices. Sit back, relax, and enjoy the show. And thank you for coming.
Almost ready, Mom!
Hurry up!
Trying.
If you're late to school, you'll miss out, and then you'll be an idiot. Don't be an idiot!
I'm not an idiot!
Faster. You don't want to be weak. Are you weak?
I'm not weak, sir!
Go get me some laps.
Drive the lane.
You can't even drive a car.
Watch this.
Brick.
Nice shot, Dyke.
Not cool.
Mike, forget it.
Forget it, faggot. You and your sick in the head friend should get off my court.
He's not worth it.
I'm not sick in the head.
And don't call people faggot.
It makes you look like a backwards idiot.
I'll kill him, I swear.
You're never gonna pass if you don't study.
I studied, Marcel.
It's easy. Are you retarded or something?
Don't call me retarded.
I'm just saying.
Casey, don't be a bitch. I know what I want. A glazed donut cut in half, toasted like a bagel with cream cheese.
Excuse me?
A glazed donut toasted like a bagel with cream cheese.
Seriously?
Yeah, why?
It'll make you fat. You don't want that. You're such a cute little thing.
Don't judge people by their appearances.
Don't be fat. Easy fix.
Wow. Popular doesn't mean you get to mess with me.
I'm not.
Just
quit making fun of me!
to make you my bitch!
Language!
Sorry, Dad!
No sorries! Turn that crap off!
Dad!
Off now! I'll show you the sting of my belt! Playing that crap will make you a violent deviant.
I'm not gonna turn into a violent deviant! Jeez. James?
Go.
Go!
Hello? Hello?
Hello?
Can anybody hear me? I'm not an idiot. I'm not sick in the head. Don't call people faggot. I'm not weak. Don't call me retarded. Don't judge people by their appearances. Quit making fun of me. I'm not going to turn into a... Can anybody hear me? I'm not an idiot! I'm not sick in the head! Don't call people faggot! I'm not weak! Don't call me retarded! Don't judge people by their appearances! Quit making fun of me! I'm not going to turn into a... Can anybody hear me?
Not me.
Not sick in the head. Don't call people faggot. I'm not weak. Don't call me retarded. Don't judge people by their appearances. Quit making fun of me. I'm not going to turn into... Hello? Can anybody hear me? I just want to feel better.
When we first heard the news that James Smith walked into Lincoln High School and opened fire, killing 14, including himself, and injuring 19 others. It's been 10 years, and Dateline is back in the sleepy community to talk with several of the students and see how surviving has affected their lives.
You okay?
I'm totally nervous.
You'll be great. Just be yourself and speak clearly.
Ready?
She's nervous.
No need to be. It's not live, just a raw footage interview.
What's that mean?
We'll ask you a bunch of questions, get your answers. Just be yourself. We'll do it a couple of different times, a couple of different ways, with different questions. Open up different parts of your mind. You, guide me. Then we'll edit it all in post-production. Promise. We won't make you look bad. Thank you. Rolling?
Yup.
Great. You ready?
Yeah.
Let's start easy. What's your name?
I'm Sarah. There's no H when you put that up on the screen.
Seems important to you.
Yeah. Not really. I mean, it's kind of part of my identity.
Identity?
Yeah. In high school, I would totally flip out if I went to Starbucks and the barista put an H on my cup.
Well, why's that?
Well, Sarah with an H was kind of a bitch. Not really. I mean, I shouldn't say that now that she's, you know.
Dead.
Yes. Dead.
You're speaking of Sarah Denvers, yes. Victim 11.
Yeah, we never really got along after the 7th grade.
You got along before that?
We were totally best friends before that.
What did she do? Or was it you that did something?
Well, she started hanging out with different people. She got boobs faster than most of the other girls. It doesn't surprise me though, have you seen her mother? Anyways, all the boys wanted to talk to her and she started wearing shirts that, let's say, showed off her assets. I told her it was dumb and that the only reason that boys wanted to talk to her was because of fat and flesh. But she totally got pissed at me and said that the only reason that I was mad was because I belonged to the Itty Bitty Titty Committee. She wasn't lying, but she didn't have to be so rude about it. Anyways, all the boys hanging around her made her popular with the popular girls, and that sort of left me standing outside of the circle as they laughed and giggled down the hallway like a bunch of idiotic chimps.
Get any revenge?
What?
Did you seek retribution?
Well, I knew I still had my books, and I knew that someday I was going to be better than her.
Really?
Yeah, that was totally going to be my revenge. I'd come back from my big important work trip in Zurich, and on my way back to my big fancy apartment in whatever big metropolitan city I was living in at the time, I'd swing by here for a weekend, visit my parents, and my mom would go ask me to get her some milk. And I wouldn't even ask her for a credit card because I could afford to buy milk for my parents. And then there would be Sarah with an H in the McDonald's, in the Walmart, because there was nothing worse than working in a fake McDonald's in a Walmart. She'd wave me over, tell me about her deadbeat husband and her 14 little brats. And I'd just smile and nod. I wouldn't even tell her about my success. I'd let her guess at it. And when she finally got around to asking me how I was doing, I'd say, well, I can afford 2 boob jobs, but unlike you, I don't need a nice rack for people to pay attention to me. Then I'd make her ring me up for my milk, and I'd hand her my black American Express card and beam. It sounds so stupid now.
It sounds like the mind of a teen.
Yeah, I guess. Thank you.
What is it?
Nothing.
Don't you want to feel better? It'll make you feel better.
Yeah.
Well, tell us.
2 weeks before it happened, she sent me a friend request on Facebook. I've never told anybody this. I didn't respond. I thought it was a trick, like she was totally going to be mean to me or something. After it happened, you know, when James happened, I saw them on the night before the shooting. She sent me a private message apologizing for everything. She wanted to make up for a long time. She just didn't know how to start. She felt bad. Can we stop this?
No! What are you thinking?
What?
What's going on in your head?
I'm going to look like a horrible person. Everybody deifies the dead. I'm just telling you what I thought.
Just say it. Everyone understands. It'll make you feel better, and we can always cut it later if you want to.
Really?
Sure.
On the day of the shooting, she waved to me in the hallway. She assumed I saw the message, I guess. I flipped her off. Again, thinking it was all a trick or something if I'd only checked my messages before school. I would have waved back.
Did the message offer an explanation for her actions?
Kind of. In the private message, she said that the only reason she hadn't tried anything before was because I had been so cold to her every time she tried to open that door to renewed friendship. I guess I held a grudge because I thought she hated me when, in reality, I hated her. I guess she didn't think about me much for all those years. Don't hold grudges. They're emotionally inefficient and they sap up your time and energy. And no good comes from it.
You were kids. Can you blame either of you for that grudge?
Well, I know she was only young and dumb when she walked away. Only 12. And I know we were only 17 when it happened. But I guess in those 5 years, she grew up. And I sort of remained the child. And then she was dead.
What's changed in you in all these years?
Well, I don't want to go to Zurich anymore. And I don't mind as much when the barista at Starbucks puts an H at the end of my name.
Let's take a break and try one more time. Maybe cry next time.
What can I get you?
Vodka and cranberry juice.
Hi.
Hello.
I'm Robert.
Hi, Robert.
Have you lived here all your life? Excuse me? Have you lived here your whole life?
No, I just moved here.
I have. Lived my whole life here. You know what happened here like six years ago?
The shooting thing?
Yeah.
Yeah, everyone knows about that.
Well, what you don't know is I was there.
No way.
Yeah, I was in a hallway. Yeah, I almost stopped it.
You what?
Yeah. Pop, pop, pop! It's what the guns sound like. It echoed down the hallway. Firecrackers? And we thought anything of it. Until we heard the screaming. You hear about stuff like that. See on the news or whatever. I always like to think I was the kind of person to do something about it. Be, I don't know, like a superhero or something. Batman, Superman, Iron Guy or something like. I seriously planned this out. It's pretty awesome. Yeah. Listen, if you need to get back to, you know, your dream.
No, it's okay.
Oh. Well, hello, beautiful. How did I get so lucky? Sorry, Yeah.
Yeah, just.
I won't do it again.
I'm sure.
It's just, difficult.
Yeah. Your plan?
Right. I thought if I toss him at the dude, because it's always dude, like, really chuck something at him, like a book or something. I thought it could give me enough time to, you know, like, charge the guy, because he ducked, because, you know, that's what a person does when something flies at his face. And I'd run zigzag patterns so he couldn't hit me. And if he did, it'd just be a flesh wound or whatever, and a cool scar. And then I'd tackle him, I'd knock him to the ground, and then pop, pop! I'd put two in him. But, only the knees. I wouldn't kill him, like, one, two, three. some answer for your debt and stuff. Maybe get some answers for the families of the kids who didn't make it. Because I always see those families crying on TV or whatever, and I always wonder why no one didn't do anything about it. I mean, it would just take two kids. Two brave kids running from different directions. I mean, one might get hit, but plan for this kind of thing. With a friend or by yourself. Think of all the dates I could have had. All the girls would have wanted me. Right?
Sure. But I thought you said you stopped him.
No, I said almost.
Oh my god, did you get shot?
No. Pop Pops were coming closer. 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 And, tears. I couldn't stop crying. You see, I knew when I heard the screaming, I wasn't gonna do it. Charge him, I mean. I'm weak. I couldn't stop thinking of my mom and dad and what they look like on TV.
That's awful.
Yeah.
Dude. Keep telling people that stupid story. I'll have to kick you out of here.
Fair enough.
I assume the other boob's got a name.
You're such a dork.
You married this dork. It's amazing that your school's not even a union.
James doesn't need to rob us of everything.
But this is kind of depressing.
Kind of is being kind.
Oh my god.
Mike?
Megan! You look so good! It's been
way too long!
Yeah.
You look fantastic!
Thank you. Do say more.
Sorry. This is my husband, David.
This is my husband, Eddie.
Hello.
Nice to meet you.
Oh my god, I can't believe you're gay!
I can't believe you're not.
Oh my god, what a freaking surprise!
You're telling me she was a crazy basketball star. Super sporty. I thought for sure you were a dyke.
No offense. None taken. But that's an awful stereotype, calling all sporty girls dykes. You should know better.
He thinks he can get away with it because he's a modern day gay. I tell him he can't.
He's going to tell him. And from what I remember playing basketball with you, you need that.
Ouch.
And for the record, I'm still sporty.
Please sit with us, add some legs to the table.
Thanks.
What is it?
Shut up and let me look at you. I haven't seen that face in so long. Where did you go?
A journey of self-discovery.
And Eddie discovery.
I can't believe this.
What?
This makes so much sense. I wanted you so bad in high school. Sorry.
Please, take him.
That's okay. I'm quite happy with this one. Straight it up, no offense.
None taken. He's quite the specimen.
That's what I can tell her.
So, what have you been up to?
Well, I played college basketball on a scholarship. It's where I met David. Almost made the WNBA. But I guess it wasn't in the cards. Now I'm a defensive coach at the university.
No.
Yeah.
That's so perfect. Kids?
No.
Oh.
I can't have kids. They were hopeful, but I just had too much scar tissue.
From what?
Eddie.
It's okay. I was shot at the school.
Sorry.
You didn't do it. How about you guys, kids?
Two.
Adopted.
No, really. Oh, did Dateline call you about that anniversary special?
Yeah, how tacky. Who would even do that? It's disgusting.
I'm doing it.
I'm sorry, I'm kidding! Oh, God, you bitch. God. I didn't know how I was gonna talk myself out of that one.
That's a first.
Oh, you stop acting all tough.
Hey, Megan, Mike. Dudes, I didn't go to school with.
Steve?
Yup. Look, this place sucks. Hey, a bunch of us are going out later. Hit up the White Horse.
Thanks, we'll catch up with you in a bit.
Yeah?
Yeah, sounds awesome, man. Thanks for the invite.
Do you want to go?
God, no.
It's terrible. That's the only way to get rid of him.
Just agree with the plan or you're going to hear for an hour why you're wrong.
That guy was always disrupting our lives.
Some things never change.
I bet he's the only one going to the White Horse.
That's awful.
No, that's survival.
Man, I forgot that guy even existed.
I can't believe how dead this place is.
Yeah, hasn't been last time it's been this summer some kid shot the place up.
Megan!
You're terrible.
Well, I was shot right outside that door, actually, so I can make a joke.
Can you believe they put all the pictures up?
They can't pretend like it didn't happen.
That's what I keep trying to tell him.
Don't.
He saved my life.
What?
What?
Yeah.
No, I didn't.
You did.
I did what anybody else would have done.
Bull!
What happened?
Let's change the
Well, we were running down the hallway, and before I knew it, I was hit right above the pelvic bone.
It could have been either of us.
But it wasn't. So I'm lying there, and he keeps running. Mike almost made it to a classroom when I called out his name. He turned around, he saw me bleeding, and came back.
You still owed me like $6.
Stop deflecting.
It's not a big deal, just instinct.
I'm not gonna let you minimize this. You could have gotten shot.
Not even close.
James hadn't left the hallway yet. So I'm lying there and he tried to stop the flow of blood with his hands, but they just weren't stemming it. So he rips off his shirt like some bad 80s action hero and holds it over my stomach. To top it off, he shielded me with his body. He stayed like that till the paramedics came. They said I would have died from blood loss if it wasn't for Mike. You know what I thought that whole time?
What?
I have to get freaking shot for you to lay your shirtless body on top of me. I should have known you were gay.
You should come over sometime. Meet the kids. Teach them a little basketball.
I will, because I know you're not teaching them anything.
Trash talk?
You want to go outside and settle this?
The kids will love you.
No deflecting. Find a ball.
Over.
blitz that he knows.
Let's go, ladies. Take five.
Football is my life. It always has been. When I was a little baby, I slept with a football. I remember my dad drilling it into me when I played Pop Warner how important it was that I go pro. He always told me at the very least football would pay for my college education. But if I was good enough, I could get drafted by the NFL, make millions, buy a house, marry a Playboy bunny, and retire after only working 7 years, never having to work again. But only if I was good enough. I didn't love school or have direction, so it sounded good to me. I worked and I worked and I worked so hard to make my dad proud. He pulled me out of the Pop Warner Football League when I was 8 because they didn't keep individual stats. Moved me to a league 3 hours away. He'd have to pull me out of school early sometimes so I could make games and practices on time. See, he wanted to track my stats against the other kids so he could monitor how well I was doing. He used it to show people, scouts. I started out as a quarterback, but I blew out my shoulder when I was 14. I was fast as hell, so they made me a wide receiver, which, don't tell my dad, I liked a whole lot more. Less pressure. I'm no good at pressure. Last year we won the state championship. I was a junior, I rode the pine a lot, but damn! If that wasn't the best day of my life. My dad was so proud. Before that day, he never looked at me with such pride. Not even when I aced a test or got my driver's license. He's done it once since then. Just this beaming pride. He thinks I didn't start much because I wasn't a senior, but I know it's because I wasn't really good enough. Whenever the scouts came to watch the team play, they never paid me any attention. Even the Division II schools didn't show interest. And because my dad was always pulling me out of school early, I never really had good grades. So I guess it all works out. I guess it's good James shot me. I was number 6. Got me in a classroom. I was trying to hold the door closed. I braced it with my body. I mean, I don't know why I didn't think the bullets would go through the door, but they did. I was shot 17 times. It was the last one that did it. Hit my heart. I went pretty quick after the last one. My body blocked him from opening the door, so I saved a bunch of freshmen. Pathetic, huh? Taking a computer class with a bunch of freshmen because I couldn't pass it the other 2 times I took it. I mean, it's good. I'd hate to think that I'd be alive at 50, working some dead-end construction job with blown-out knees to match my blown-out shoulder, knowing that I peaked as a junior in high school. I'd hate to see the disappointment on my dad's face when I didn't make the NFL. This way the peak works out. Happened at the right time. This way, I get a full page in the yearbook. This way, I'm always remembered like this, my prime. This way I don't have to avoid all those embarrassing questions at high school reunions. This way, football can always be my life. Oh. The other time my dad looked at me with pride was when he looked in my casket. The freshmen. They all came to the funeral and told him what I did. That was nice of them.
That bastard!
That's it! Out!
She's a bitch out to scam us!
Out!
Don't read her book! Don't read her book! You're what's wrong with America! Trying to get rich off the backs of the dead! You're disgusting to belong in hell with your boyfriend!
I'm sorry. I don't like that. I don't like to have that happen, but things have gotten pretty hairy up in here. The big lug is just for everybody's protection. The book is called Understanding James. It's a retrospective of all of my thoughts on James from first meeting until now. The book is made up of various parts. Some chapters are my thoughts from before the shooting, some after. Some chapters are my thoughts after reading studies and research, consulting with therapists, talking with James's family, talking with James's best friend, and the current expert in spree shootings, Dr. Sean Northman, that kind of thing. About 2 years ago, I went back and reread my diary from that time. This entry that I'm about to read to you is actually what prompted me to write the book. It describes the first independent thought that I had about the shooting. It's what I wanted to tell people when I heard them talking about James and the shooting. This was written 2 months after the shooting. Oh, and I should mention that these entries are just the virtually untouched thoughts of the mind of a child. I cleaned up spelling and whatnot, but that's it. You know, I lied. I've been lying this whole press tour. Those untouched things are just something that I tell people. This is my diary from that time, and everything is factual. I lied when I said I only cleaned it up a little. I did some big time editing, and I don't know why I say that, probably to protect me from my detractors and distance. And honestly, I don't know why I'm telling you the truth now, but there it is anyways. We kind of dated once, not like seriously or anything, just one date. And we went to the dance together and hung out at his place a couple of times. This was all last year, way before he killed all of those kids. And he broke it off with me, so I didn't have anything to do with the shooting. It's not like I jilted him, and that's the reason. I don't have a ton of friends. Neither does he. A lot of people thought he was strange. A lot of people think I'm strange, but they just didn't know him. He could be a really sweet guy. One time, his dad was supposed to pick him up from school and hang out with him. See, James' mom and dad got a divorce, and James' dad never really came around. He was more interested in the bottle, if you know what I mean. And to tell you the truth, I think he might have been in jail or something. That's just the kind of impression I got from the kinds of things said at James' house. Besides the point, his dad was supposed to pick him up that day and hang out with him. James thought his dad was awesome, hated his mom, thought she was the reason the family broke up. But I guess most kids hate the parents they live with and idolize the ones that's not around. So his dad doesn't show, and instead of getting angry or something, he picked me up and took me for cheese fries. Said it's what his dad used to do with him. He wanted to cry, but he didn't. I felt bad. James was a really smart kid. He told me that you can't choose your real family, but you can always choose those you make family. And he told me that he wanted to make me family. He told me that he loved me and said that he would never do anything to hurt me like his family hurt him. And then he started crying. He broke up with me a week later, said he wasn't really interested anymore because I wouldn't put out. At first, I thought it might be true, and then I realized I think he's just afraid of his emotions, showing them at least. It's vulnerable. I mean, my mom said he didn't know love, but I think he knew love. I mean, I showed him plenty of love. I think he just didn't know what to do with it. On the day of the shooting, We all heard the shots in the classrooms. People were scared. I thought I was going to die. A girl, Janelle, came running down the hallway. She had some blood on her. She was freaking out. She wasn't saying a lot that made sense, but I heard her say James did it. I was out of the classroom before the teacher could stop me. I could hear panic screams, cries of pain. The gunshots were getting closer. When I got to the end of the hallway, I saw James. I yelled his name and he turned to me. I said, "What are you doing?" He told me to move. He wanted to go down the hallway. Again, I asked, "What are you doing?" He pointed the gun at me and told me to move, said he had things to do. I told him that he would have to shoot me to get by. He shoved me and made a move to get around me, but I stepped towards him. "Remember the cheese fries? What about the family we chose? Are you just gonna break that promise that you made to me again?" He looked like he was going to cry. I stepped towards him. He stepped back real fast. He put the gun to his head and boom. They say I saved a lot of people that day, and I'm proud of that. I just have to realize. I hate that people keep talking about what an awful person he is, or try to simplify what he did. What his life came to was not an easy answer, and there were a lot of factors. People forget that. He is still my friend. He will always be my first boyfriend, the first person I loved, first boy I kissed, and there's nothing wrong with me, so how could there be something wrong with him? He's still someone's son. He's still human. He's still the first person I chose to be my family. I try not to say that often because it doesn't get me any friends, and when I'd say that to my mom, she'd slap me. But I still think it needs to be said. Questions?
Anybody else want to speak tonight? Janelle.
You can do this.
I can't.
You came back here, didn't you? You're clean, aren't you? You're Wonder Woman. You can do anything. Who are you?
I'm Wonder Woman.
Damn right you are.
Hi, my name is Janelle.
Hi, Janelle.
I'm addicted to anything that will make me forget. Mostly heroin when I can afford it. I've been completely clean about 3 weeks, and other than two setbacks, I've been clean almost 9 months. I've lost a lot of progress, but I'll get it back. This isn't my normal meeting. I wanted to use so bad tonight, so I called my sponsor, and he found a meeting. Ironic, the only meeting is here, at Lincoln High School. I didn't want to come, but that should just show how hard I'm trying to kick this. This is the place I'm trying to forget. This school has ghosts.
Face your ghosts.
I was a student here at Lincoln when... I don't usually talk about this. When James Smith killed all those people. I didn't have an off-school lunch pass, but I ditched my friends, Casey and Marcel. They were eating ice cream, vanilla, soft serve. We were just sneaking back onto campus. We were running late, I needed gas. I thought we'd had enough to get back, but we ran out. The gas station was only a block away from where the car stopped, so we pushed the car there.
three girls. I remember I thought we were strong, badasses, invincible, able to do anything the boys could do, but with more style and substance. I bought them ice cream at the gas station for helping me push. It's what friends do. Casey had a billion tardies already. Another one and she'd be suspended, so we had to be super careful when we came back in. Marcel kept talking about prom. A senior had asked her out. It's silly. She was so concerned. She was afraid she had to put out or something. I remember I told her it wasn't 1982 anymore, and those forever ago rules were dumb and outdated. She didn't have to put out if she didn't want to, or if she was expected to because it was prom or whatever. Then the boy she was with wasn't worthy of her time or her flower. And that was the biggest concern we'd have. And we'd actually call it her flower. What idiots. And that's when the shots came. I could tell they were close. Before we could run, he came around the corner. He looked at me, James. Everyone always thought he was a freak. Me too, honestly, but I didn't think he'd do something like that. Everyone thought he was such a freak, they usually went out of their way to be mean to him. He looked at me. And then Marcel. And Casey. Marcel dropped her ice cream and screamed. He shot her first. In the face. He had to sweep the gun across my path to get from one to the other, and then he shot Casey in the chest. And then he smiled at me. It was kind. I had seen it before. A week earlier, he forgot a pen, so I let him have one. When he tried to give it back at the end of first period, I told him no, he would need it for the rest of the day. He asked me if I didn't want it back because he had touched it. That made me sad for him. I told him no, it's silly. He would need it for the rest of the day and he could give me the pen back in the morning. Then he smiled, the kind smile. He told me he owed me one. I didn't think of that in the moment when he killed Marcel and Casey. I only thought of that after. I wonder if they gave him a pen. When I shoot up, I forget. Just go to another world. It's like a switch that turns my brain off. I forget that if I didn't run out of gas, we'd be in a class in a hallway he never went near, and my friends would still be alive. If he really wanted to pay back my kindness, he would have shot me when he shot them. Maybe that's what I try to do when I shoot up. Too scared for suicide, so go for an accidental on-purpose overdose, be able to forget. Forever. James came around the corner towards this very classroom. Actually, the image I can't get out of my head, the one that keeps me doped up, it's not my two best friends or even him. It's the melting vanilla ice cream and the blood. The two puddles overlapped. Pure white and dark red mixing in the middle to make the prettiest shade of pink I've ever seen. This was a mistake coming here. I wanted you so bad.
You don't have to use.
We've got you covered.
Thank you. Thank you, thank you.
Thank you.
Ladies and gentlemen, I am so excited. Dr. Sean Northman is a brilliant mind who has been studying spree shootings and the psychology of spree shooters ever since he was involved at that incident at Lincoln High. Folks, Dr. Sean Northman.
Thank you. This isn't my normal lecture. I've been inspired. I hope you've all read Molly's book, Understanding James. It's been inspiring to me in that she talks about her experience. I've never really talked about my experience before. I've always remained a bit removed. My best friend killed 14 people. That puts his spree at Lincoln High School number 5 on the list of most deadly school shootings. Following Virginia Tech, Sandy Hook, University of Texas, and Columbine. That's 33, 27, 16, 15, and 14. I've done a ton of research to try and understand, or, you know, I think everybody wants to know the answers, but nobody's asking the right questions. Honestly, I still struggle to make. Sung Hui Cho got his 33 kills in 36 minutes. It only took Adam Lanza 10 minutes. 10 minutes to kill 27, mostly kindergartners. Charles Whitman sat up in a clock tower and picked off 16 people over 96 minutes on a lazy August afternoon at the University of Texas. Eric Harris and Dylan Claybold tag team to kill 15 people in 51 minutes. And that brings us to James. James killed 14 people that I knew in 17 minutes. That's 104 dead students and teachers in less than 3 hours and 30 minutes of elapsed time. I tell you, all this research and I still struggle to make. In 2013, there were 33 incidents of gun violence on school property in the US. That's almost 3 a month. What's really screwed up? In the 30 days after Adam Lanza killed 27 out of school, mostly 5-year-olds, there were 9 school shootings. While an entire country was in mourning, 9 people thought it was a good idea to enter a school with a gun and cause havoc. I don't know what any of this means, and most of these shooters wind up dead, so it's not like we can ask questions. I mean, something is happening. There is an escalation. There has to be a reason. People are so quick to blame video games, violent movies, or TV. They blame gun control laws. We should have them, we shouldn't. They blame automatic weapons. They blame teachers or bullying or even parents. They call these shooters loners or losers, say they have mental deficiencies. They blame depression, retardation, mental health, medications, and I'm pretty sure all of those things can and do factor in one way or another. But the truth is, any single one of those is just an oversimplification of the greater problem. It's ignoring the complexities and holding these shooters at an arm's distance. Like, we could have fixed them if we had solved that one simple problem. If only they didn't play Grand Theft Auto or Watch Kill Bill, or took an antidepressant, or didn't take an antidepressant, or had more friends, or didn't have access to guns. It gives us this false idea that we can somehow stop it from happening again. And it gives parents and friends and the community as a whole something to hate and point a finger at. It gives the media buzzwords and a great story. A villain. But in these situations, nobody is bad or born evil. James wasn't. And to be clear, I am not condoning his actions. He had a major, major lapse in judgment. But he wasn't evil. You've all heard the term suicide cluster. It's a documented phenomenon. For example, one kid in a small town commits suicide. Shortly after, several follow. They don't have to know each other or go to the same high school. They could even have different reasons for the suicide. But either way, there is an increase in suicides when compared to the national average. Studies show that hearing about a suicide seems to make those who are vulnerable feel they have the permission to do it, especially if they feel close to or know somebody who was close to the original circumstances of the suicide. It can spread by word of mouth, but also by the media. The month Marilyn Monroe died, there were over 200 more suicides than the national average. Upon hearing of someone else's suicide, people can decide that the action of suicide is appropriate for them as well, especially if the publicized suicide was of someone in a similar situation as them. People imitate those who seem similar, despite or even because of societal disapproval. Because of this, many countries such as Turkey and Norway refuse to publicize suicide in the media. Another interesting fact about suicide, many people interviewed after the suicide of a relative or a friend have a tendency to oversimplify the issues. Their grief can lead to simplifying the issues or minimizing or ignoring the significant factors. I know, I thought this was about school shootings, not suicides. Well, in the month following the 24-hour news media coverage of Adam Lanza killing 27, there were 9 school shootings. Adam Lanza's rampage falls on the heels of James Holmes killing 12 and injuring 70, just a few short miles away from the first highly publicized school shooting at Columbine. I don't know, but maybe our obsession with idolizing these shooters and reducing them down to people who play video games or who are being bullied is sending a pretty scary message to those who are being bullied or who do play video games that this is an answer. That shooting up a school is an answer. But then again, that's just oversimplifying. And even though I've studied all this for years, I don't claim to have the answers. I have the facts, the statistics, and that's 33, 27, 16, 15, and 14 dead, all including the shooter. Let's not forget, they were victims too, not simply villains. I'm not suggesting that we sympathize. I'm asking that we empathize. To find the shooter in us. Not to look for the simple excuse, but the truth. And the truth is, my best friend in high school killed 14 people. He wasn't a terrible guy. He just did a terrible thing. And nobody will ever know why. Thank you.
Hello, everybody. I've never been able to speak clearly yet. I get these ideas, and I vomit them out. But just try to follow me, please. When I was a child and thought of my future, I always imagined I'd be a great lover of woman. Rich. Famous, maybe. I'd find the cure to cancer, or be a great writer. An actor. A football player. I was always good at sports. When I closed my eyes, my future was bright. It was always on the grandest scale. I thought I'd be the best, a researcher, a scientist, that my life would be the best. I was special and destined for greatness. I mean, I knew it. One in a million. But I guess every kid thinks that way. Nobody says, when I grow up, I want to be divorced. Be a failure as a husband and a father. I mean, as a kid, my dad didn't think that. I want to lose my job, have a mental illness, or end up in a wheelchair. Be bullied. Be a bully. I want to be an alcoholic or an addict. Nobody wants to beat their wives. Nobody wants to murder, rape, be a pedophile. But these kinds of people are out there. When you're young, the path from childhood to adulthood is easy. You can see it. But that's part of the illusion. The illusion that not everybody wins in the end. This is where adults fail children. Where teachers and parents suck. Here. When they fail to tell us that not everybody wins in the end. You know, they should sit us down and say, hey, you see that over there? Well, take a good look. Because that's as close as you're getting. It's not being mean. It's being realistic. Not everybody's dreams come true. Sometimes you wander off the path and end up. When you're young, you're always told it's gonna be better. That your life is full of potential. But old people always say that youth is wasted on the young. So I guess, when is it ever good? When are you anything, really? Or maybe you're just born defective. That's the easy answer. The one they want to give when something like this happens. But easy answers are stupid! You know, that's something else they should teach us kids. The adults, I mean. They should teach us that life is solitude. It's not something you experience with others. We are each marching forward in unison, separately. When that solitude becomes so loud that you lose all track of yourself, values you hold close dissipate. To be my age and know the path that was so clear 8 years ago will never, ever appear again. That it's lost for you. And when that solitude becomes deafening, who knows how you'll react? Because when I was little, I certainly did not wish that my life would end up like this. That I would walk into a school and sorry. I'm really sorry. I'm sorry. It's a thing that I do. I'm rambling. It's a thing that I do. I can't collect my thoughts. And people don't like it.
Arrivals are happening with greater frequency.
Shut up, Roger.
Someone get Spencer.
You go, bitch.
What do you think his number is?
Why do you think he did it?
Yeah. Why do you think he did it?
Wake him.
Spencer isn't here yet.
Wake him.
Put your hands on me again, I'll beat you to look like Roger.
One-on-one, I'll kill you, jarhead!
I'm not a six-year-old, I'm gonna make it tough for you.
Hoorah, bitch!
Stop it.
I looked them in the face, not from a freaking tower!
Stop it. He's waking.
Welcome, James.
Shut up, Boy Scout.
Who are you?
Ask him why he did it.
Why'd you do it?
Give the kid a chance to speak.
Shut up.
Think you're so tough?
I got a higher count than you.
I'm surprised you can count. You take your shoes off to make the 20?
Yeah, and I still need 8 more digits to count my kills.
You just stood on a tower picking people off.
Yeah, you went in the thick of it.
There were 2 of you morons. Your kills should be half.
Again?
Standby argument.
Little baby's just so sad his number didn't hold up. Wah, wah, wah.
I'd love to gut you, Lonza. Killing baby's real tough, huh?
I hate to agree with Jarhead.
Young people, Lonza is bomb at Call of Duty.
The truth. So right, Harris.
Pop, pop, pop.
I love Call of Duty.
Why did you do it? She'll want to know.
Speak up or we'll toss you in the corner with Roger.
You're lucky we let you out of that corner, Lonza.
Shut up!
Children! Why did you do it?
I guess I was mad and I wanted people to pay.
What were you mad about? Is your question?
Yes, please.
Boys got manners. Take notes, Lonza.
What did you use?
4 Glocks and a shotgun.
Kills?
14.
Yes!
Still second.
Injuries?
Injuries come for crap, Jarhead!
That's because you're dead last with 2.
Injuries?
19, I think.
That puts you 4th if we count by incidents, 3rd by individual totals.
It's like a broken record.
Just give it a rest.
I'm tired of hearing it.
Yeah, tired of hearing
it. Shut up. Introduce yourselves.
Adam Lanza, Sandy Hook. 28 dead, 2 injured.
Charles Whitman, University of Texas, Austin. 16 dead, 32 injured.
Eric Harris, Dylan Klebold, Columbine. Columbine. 15 killed, 21 injured.
Sung Kwai Cho, Virginia Tech. 33 dead, 23 injured.
Hi, I'm James Smith. 14 killed, 19 injured. But you already knew that.
Roger. Did we cut his tongue out?
No.
And we?
Please.
Maybe. Speak, Roger. I believe I said, speak, Roger.
Elliot Roger, University of California, Santa Barbara. 7 dead, 13.
Shouldn't even be here with us.
Gives us a bad name.
Brenda Spencer? I killed 2 and injured 9, picking people off at Cleveland Elementary School from the comfort of my own home with the gun my daddy bought me for Christmas. Please don't try to screw me.
I wouldn't.
Why? Is there something wrong with me?
No. I was just... I wouldn't do that with you.
Good. Because he did!
What?
Nobody touches Mama without paying the price.
That is, unless she wants to be touched.
Swear to God, Whitman! She's the reason we're all here.
What, not me? Are we gonna ignore history? I predate her by 13 years.
She's a legend!
Yeah,
a legend!
The first modern shooter, the rest of us born of her.
Charles, you inspire me, but I take the onus on me like you never could. That's why I'm responsible for all who came after. Except for Roger, he's a pig!
Mama, tell the new kid what you told the reporter when he asked why you did it.
I told the man, I don't like Mondays.
Can you believe that?
So elegant and amazing.
That can't be the reason she did it, is it?
Don't question Mama.
It's a fair question, Adam. Truth, I did want to get on TV. And everybody made fun of me because I was ugly, and a lesbian, and I was an alcoholic, I was suicidal, lived in poverty. I asked my dad for a radio for Christmas, and he bought me a gun. I think he wanted me to kill myself. He beat me! And raped me! And I was drinking. And I was on drugs. And I have an injured temporal lobe. And I seriously hate Mondays.
All that true?
As far as we know.
Yes, it is.
What about the rest of you? Why'd you do it?
Gentlemen, answer the boy's question. Sung Kwai, you first.
Violent movies, I guess. Kill Bill, RoboCop, Cannibal Holocaust, Rambo. The Softlix, Battle Royale, and then a lot of porn. Rape porn.
We were video games.
Yeah.
Doom. We were freaking obsessed.
Never stopped playing. You know, I was once up 36 straight hours playing that game.
I made a mod.
Yeah.
My life's work. Made it just like the school.
So rad. Practice killing there. Oh, Mortal Kombat.
GoldenEye 007.
Grand Theft Auto. 3, 4, Vice City, and
GTA.
Yeah. You know, they said I played Counter-Strike.
Gah! I love that game!
You Windows or Xbox, Joe?
I never played! I hate video games!
Dude.
Not cool. You know, at first I gave the credit for my work to my brother Ryan. Pissed me off. He's a huge Mass Effect fan, and he'd never heard a fly. Weakness. Media spread the story that I was obsessed with Call of Duty, and I never even tried that game until these two idiots pulled me into it. I'm kind of obsessed now.
So why'd you do it?
Don't you know? I had access to guns, and I'm a freaking loony! That simple, or so it seems. My dad, after I killed the 28, he told the media he wished I'd been aborted. He said he always wanted to abort me, get rid of me. He meant like before the shooting, like before I was born.
Adam, he didn't mean that. He was lashing out.
Thanks, Mama, but I think he meant it. That's why I'm all messed up!
Marines, I saw stuff. War games, violence, just a cycle of violence. It was in me.
I don't like Mondays.
How about him?
No one gives a crap.
Speak, Roger.
I had a problem.
Truthful.
I hate women.
Tell him what you said, virgin.
On your feet! Loud and proud, just like the video!
I'm a 22-year-old virgin! I couldn't understand why women wouldn't sleep with me. I'm the perfect guy. A supreme gentleman. And all they wanted were those obnoxious guys. So I wanted to kill all the sluts in the sororities who repeatedly denied my sexual advances. If I couldn't have the girls, I was gonna destroy them. They denied me my happiness. I deserved my happiness. I deserved what they were giving away.
You don't deserve anything! Women like Mama have rights!
Our bodies are not your privilege.
We all took lies!
Still, you're the biggest cockroach.
Don't act like you're better than me. Like you hate me for what I did. You hate me because I'm the new guy!
Maybe.
Lanza killed kindergartners!
And he took his turn!
Bunch of cowards! Pack mentality. Need to feel superior.
Someone's gotta be at the bottom of the food chain.
You'll do for now.
You know, you guys are worse than those obnoxious frat guys attacking one of your own.
You are not one of us!
You thought you were rotting in loneliness before? Who's the alpha male now, bitch?
I want to be the new guy.
You won't be for long.
And we like you.
Really?
Sure.
Awesome. I knew I was like you guys.
We can be your family, James, if you choose us.
Okay. Yeah. So how old are you guys?
Whitman's the oldest at 25. I'm 23. Douchebag here is 22. 20. Paris is 18. Klebold is 17. And Mama's 16.
The youngest.
The best. What?
Where are we?
We're immortal.
Wait. No, I'm dead. I put the gun to my own head and I pulled the trigger.
We all did.
I didn't. What? I was shot by the cops.
You're splitting hairs and you know it. Okay, jerk. You were suicide by cop, but still a suicide.
But we're all dead?
Mama isn't.
What?
She's in a jail cell somewhere.
Yet we roam free every time someone brings a gun to school.
Or a violent video game comes out. Or movie.
Or can't take a woman's no for an answer.
Or identifies as the loner kid.
Or when a parent drops their kid off for school in the morning. They think of us. Not the real us, but this version of us, this collective consciousness. In the minds of the people we touched, affected, we are the boogeymen. Youth and immortality. That's what we have. They don't have that. They're always getting older.
If, say, someone reached out to you, would you have done it? Would any of you have done it again?
Any takers?
It's kind of a loaded question.
I guess we'll never know.
Fair enough. I have one more question.
Shoot.
Do you feel better? Do any of you feel better after the shootings? Okay.
What about you?
What about me?
Do you feel better?